Fritz Haber and Carl Bosch were instrumental in developing a way to produce ammonia from its elements. Haber was awarded the prize, Nobel Prize in Chemistry, in 1918, and that was for the synthesis of ammonia from its elements. Before then, it was not easily done, and he helped pioneer a method using a catalyst and high pressure to take the nitrogen and hydrogen gases and then make ammonia and keep recycling the nitrogen and hydrogen gases. And then you keep pulling off the ammonia because it's condensed. And using this method, about 97% of it can be converted. Carl Bosch took this process and then ramped it up on an industrial scale. He was awarded the Nobel Prize in Chemistry in 1931, which was for the recognition of contributions to the invention and development of chemical high-pressure methods. Fertilizers, many of them come from ammonia, so we need to use lots of ammonia. Also, munitions, explosives, at some point, many of them require ammonia. If you haven't, you should really look up the history of Fritz Haber. It's fascinating, but I won't continue on with that. Let's do a problem. So we're going to do a stoichiometry problem. What's different now, though, is we have multiple reactants, and we have masses of both of those reactants. So under these conditions, we're going to calculate the mass of ammonia that can be produced, and we're also going to identify which one of the reactants is the limiting reactant. So see, that's what's different in this problem. You have both of the reactants. You don't have just one thing to worry about, you have two things to worry about. The first method I'm going to show you, I call it the brute force method. And what we're going to do is focus on one thing at a time. In other words, we'll pretend that we have the 10 grams of hydrogen and an excess of nitrogen gas. So we'll ignore the nitrogen gas. Then we'll rework the problem and we'll start from the 40 grams of nitrogen gas and pretend we have an excess of hydrogen gas and then look at the results. So we'll start with the hydrogen gas. So we've got 10.00 grams of it. We want to calculate the mass of ammonia. So recall that the coefficients in the balanced chemical equation tell us moles. And we've got grams here, which means we need the molar mass of what we're given, the hydrogen gas, and what we're trying to calculate, which is the ammonia. So right now, it's a typical stoichiometry problem, similar to what we've done before. We're pretending we only have one reactant. So we start with the mass of hydrogen gas. What can you do in one step? Convert to moles of hydrogen gas. And that's really no different than any other similar calculation we've done before this. But we're moving on. Now that we know the moles of hydrogen gas, we can use the balanced chemical equation to calculate how many moles of ammonia gas can be generated. And those are the coefficients from the balanced chemical equation. Now that we have moles of ammonia, because we're looking for ammonia, that's not what we really want. We really want mass of ammonia. So now we're going to use the molar mass, which will allow us to convert from moles to grams. And we do our unit check. That's good. So assuming we have 10.00 grams of hydrogen gas and an excess of nitrogen gas, we can make 56.32 grams of ammonia. But we don't have an excess of nitrogen gas. So now, let's do the problem again, but with the other reactant. We'll start with the 40.00 grams of nitrogen gas and convert that to ammonia. Ignore the hydrogen gas. So just like before, we need molar masses, but this time, since we're starting with the nitrogen gas, we need the molar mass of that. That's the 28.014 grams per mole. Start with what we're given. Then do a gram to mole conversion for nitrogen, N2. Now we have moles of N2. That's not what we want. The problem requests for the mass of ammonia, but we can't go from moles of N2 to mass of ammonia. We have to use the balanced chemical equation and first go to moles of ammonia. So then we'll take the moles of ammonia and use the molar mass of ammonia to convert to grams of ammonia. Check our units. Good. I didn't mention previously, but the significant figures in the answer are coming from the given masses, because the given masses, the 10.00 and the 40.00, each have four significant figures. And that's the fewest number of significant figures in this setup. Okay, so let's see where we are. So 10 grams of hydrogen gas and an excess of nitrogen gas will allow us to produce 56.32 grams of ammonia. 40.00 grams of nitrogen gas plus an excess of hydrogen gas would allow us to produce 48.64 grams of ammonia. But take a look at the bottom one. As soon as we have made, and as the reaction continues, 48.64 grams of ammonia, we've exhausted the nitrogen. We can't make 56.32 grams of ammonia because we don't have enough nitrogen gas. So when you use the brute force method like this, you do one calculation for each reactant that you have. And assuming you're comparing it to a product, like we are here, then you take a look at the different masses of product that can be generated, and your answer is the smallest one. Because as soon as you make the smallest mass of ammonia, that reactant is out. So 48.64 grams of ammonia is the mass that can be produced under these conditions, and nitrogen gas is the limiting reactant because it's the reactant that runs out first.